Was ready to. Oh, brought bot spawners.
Oh, he did bring in bot spawners, so here we go. This is the final match of the Aramech Top Gun Tournament, Game 1 between Akroz and Tangibility, and we are on Chasm. We'll do another quick intro. In the upper left-hand corner, it is Akroz, the green player in the Steampunk Warthog, with a slightly more evolved build than he's been using this entire game simply because of the map. And in the bottom right-hand corner, we have Tangibility as the blue player in the Raptor Neo, going pretty much what he did the last game, which was also on Chasm. And against Minx, it worked very, very interestingly, and he went freaking like 11, 12 levelers, and it was a little ridiculous. Akroz going full moneymaker. I don't see any levelers coming out for Akroz at all, so he is going kind of traditionally what he... Akroz needs to clear the neutrals, I think. I think that's what is pretty much holding him back. Once he clears the neutrals, he can start sending rebels everywhere, and
Tangibility already has a blaster guardian out there, so it's gonna be really interesting to see if he's gonna go right to harassing.
Yeah,
just say, you know what, I'm coming front door at you.
Oh, Akroz with one leveler, a little bit interesting. Tangi going straight across. I'm not sure why he's starting to fly over the neutrals. Maybe he wanted to intercept Akroz just in case Akroz decided to cheese, but he didn't. Now Tangi guarding his outpost with bunkered creeps, and Akroz doing the same for the bottom. And both of them do have defense for those initial jackals, so, you know, these experienced players have played on these maps a million times, obviously exaggerated. But now Tangi does hit level 2, does have Stasis Blast, and going for trying to snipe down one of Akroz's rebels. They're kind of, honestly, they've both, the entire tournament, have been playing very, very similarly, where they're very harass heavy, and have been trying to, you know, snipe out units from unit clumps and stuff like that, you know, wherever they have been strangely positioned. Akroz doing the same thing now, going with a front door attack against Tangi with those rebels, probably will get this leveler. One rebel does go down. Akroz actually front dooring. Tangi might need to bring out some seekers, and will follow Akroz down, get this kill. So Akroz killing a moneymaker, but getting killed himself, so that was sort of a good trade-off. Tangi, he didn't kill a moneymaker, he killed
that level. Nope, Tangibility got him. Tangibility takes down Akroz.
Yeah, he did. And Akroz now, Tangi now dropping at that fort, and Akroz forced to drop more rebels at that front door. But Tangi has not resocketed that leveler, and now setting down his radar vision, his radar turrets in the form of patrolling jokers. And now Tangibility able to get one more rebel, so Akroz is sort of losing this harassment battle here. You know, obviously in that hog, not as fast as that Raven Neo, but is going to try to go for this T-45. Tangi is coming back. He probably will get it before Tangi can get back to it. Oh no, Tangi does grab it in time and is chasing down Akroz. Does not decide to pursue. And now Tangi does realize, yes, I do need more anti-air here at the fort. Resockets that leveler. And now Akroz... just more and more jackals. How many moneymakers? He has 4 moneymakers out on the field. Why does Akroz only have 4 moneymakers out? Why hasn't he put more moneymakers down? It's pretty much because of Chasm. And now Tangi does realize that Akroz is sort of stationing secret jackals and does catch him in the act. Tangi hitting all those rebels with Stasis Blast. Not really super productive, but
are you, Wyatt?
Go ahead.
What time are you at right now? Sorry, it's like you're predicting the future.
Oh, I am at 1:41.
Okay, I'm 6 seconds behind
you. That's pretty funny.
I've been confused this whole time. Like, how are you saying this?
Yeah,
it hasn't even happened yet.
Okay, that's no problem, man. I'll see if I can pause it for 5 seconds.
No, you're fine.
Okay. I pause it for a few, so I'm less ahead of you. But Akroz trying to do harass against Tangi, but because of all the map vision that Tangi has, he can catch him in the act every single time. This map is definitely not anywhere as linear as other maps, and Tangi with his radar patrolling jokers are definitely doing the job. And Akroz now with freaking rebels. Why can't I say rebel? I've been saying rebel the entire time. But now Tangi has a lot of seekers here to defend. And Akroz goes down one more time. Tangi is just way ahead here in terms of, you know, he doesn't necessarily have more credits, but that's not that important because this is Chasm, and they will definitely run out of power. No one has really even started to push on mid yet. No one has started the bridges yet. It's just been drop harass attacks, and Tanji with medium, the medium attack Jokers there is going to go for and find an empty spot on that fort, and he is just going to start going with this attack here, firing at that back, but Akroz with plenty of rebels to defend. Those Jokers will go down pretty fast, but Tanji cloaking away, faking leaving, Akroz trying to find him, but Tanji, man, making a U-turn, like crazy turn there, all 100% cloaked. Definitely Akroz was not able to detect him there. That was awesome. Akroz now doing a quick scout, seeing if he can snipe anything out, but there are too many Seekers down on the field. Seeker spam is kind of the solution here, but the problem with it on other maps is the Rebels will overwhelm you for the most part, but Akroz cannot send out Rebels the way that he can on any other map in the game, and so Tanji can just sit back, relax, and wait for, that's pretty much why Tanji hasn't approached the neutrals at all, because he doesn't want to give Akroz any avenues to send Rebels here and there. And I'm a little surprised that Akroz hasn't gone for clearing the neutrals as well. It'll definitely help him more than it'll help Tanji. So I'm a little curious why he hasn't even started approaching mid or the bridges. Even clearing a single bridge would definitely put him...
I agree.
Yeah.
If you clear the bridges, you push everything there to a right outpost, it's going to be very beneficial right now for Akroz to start doing that harassment, because that's what Rebels are. They're not necessarily a defensive build. They're a harass offensive build.
Wow. Tanji dropped. Tanji just dropped. Oh, no. What happened? Oh boy. Well, this is definitely before halftime. Wow, that is craziness. Wow. Let's just say, Boblin, I hate you. You can die. That's cool, though.
What the crap, man?
That was weird. Okay, so we need to get another lobby up. Tanji, if you are listening to this, I don't know what happened there. I hope it was just a normal server disconnect and you didn't like lose your internet or something like that.
He's here.
Okay, cool.
And the next game's okay.
Okay. Man. Carbon's screwing with me at every second of this day. Okay. Oh, I had the pin on screen. Crap. Oh well. No one join. Please God, no one join. I don't know if you noticed that, but yeah, Boblin, why do what you're doing? Okay, so now we have remade the lobby. Are you in, Kirby?
I am in.
Okay, so you guys can go whenever you want. This is just not a good day. That was a really good game up until that point. Man. Oh, boy. Killing me here, Carbon. Boblin. It kind of sounds the same. Coincidence?
Maybe. So what is going to change now? They each got an experience, a little taste of everyone's opener. What is going to happen?
Well, Akroz is obviously aware that Tanji is going to go straight for dropping Jokers. Or he might not, but so that might cause Akroz to drop a little bit more defense at his fort at the beginning of the game. And honestly, I don't really see a problem with that from his perspective, because he wasn't moving out with them anyway. So, I mean, he might as well... just start to spam Rebels at his fort. And here we go one more time. This is the final match. Game one, repeat, remake, after that disconnect. Thank you, Boblin. Of the Top Gun Tournament, the Air Mech Top Gun Tournament, and it is going to be between the green player in the upper left-hand corner, Akroz in the Steampunk Warthog, and Tangibility, the blue player in the bottom right-hand corner in the Raptor Neo. Once again, this is game one of the finals, and this first map is going to be Chasm. We did have a slight snafu with the disconnect. Tanji did DC a little bit earlier in that first game, so we are remaking. And now Akroz... bringing out a lot of T-45s, actually. I don't know if it's the same exact opener that he had before. I think it's pretty close, if not the exact same thing. And Tanji dropping two Jokers there to take care of those initial Jackals. and dropping levelers as well. So Tanji going leveler, very leveler heavy. Akroz not necessarily going the same. He is going moneymakers though, actually now, and he isn't putting the moneymakers. Oh, okay, yeah, he had moneymakers here at the fort at the beginning, the last game.
Akroz also brought a leveler to, a lunchbox to this game.
Oh, he did bring a lunchbox. He has a full loadout. I guess rebels are broken on every map except for this, probably, except for Chasm. And Tanji now socketing his pre-built moneymaker, or his pre-built levelers. I'm so used to saying pre-built moneymakers. But Akroz with one moneymaker sitting at that front door for some reason. I think he'll eventually bring that out to, you know, to his bottom outpost. Yes, and he does do that, so he will socket every single thing. They're pretty fine on power. I would say they shouldn't worry too much about power, especially at the beginning of the game. And now Tanji again doing the immediate Joker harass, but now Akroz with a little bit more defense there at the beginning with Rebels doing kind of what I predicted. I thought he would have actually even more than that, dropping some Rebels to to prevent that cheese. Although I don't know if either of these players will actually go for a direct cheese. But Tanji now also changing his play style, bringing out some more anti-air to defend against that Warthog that will potentially do that harass, that that unit harass, that's that leveler sniper, whatever you want to call it, whatever he was doing at the beginning of the game last time. And definitely we have a lot less harass this game than we saw last game.
Yeah, we do. And also Tanji Boy last game only had 5 levelers on the field. Now he has 9 and a lunchbox. So Tangibility, already at level 4 now, is definitely being a little bit more aggressive with the amount of levelers in this game.
Yeah, able to take out that rebel just now. He's already at level 4. Akroz as a hog only at level 3. So I do think that, I mean, obviously because he will be able to get Blaster Guardians out a lot sooner if he levels up faster, he will have a full like armada of Blaster Guardians. And now, oh, Akroz actually has a couple of rebels at the top here that he was able to send over. And Tanji now just seeing that, but with those defensive T-45s, another one out on the field, he will probably be able to clean this up. And Akroz, using that as a distraction, might want to go for he's gonna try to go for a socket unit, but instead Tanji brings a seeker almost definitely will be able to. Oh my god, he didn't save the leveler. He was right over it and he didn't save it. Akroz is doing a lot of damage here with his hog, and those Seekers are not really positioned optimally for Tanji.
Another one
going down, and so he's almost going to go down right now. Tanji didn't decide to follow him out. I would have assumed that he would have done that, but instead decides to stay, kill the rebels at the front door. Oh man, that was really strange.
And I want to say right now, when it recognizes after Tanji's playing it, you know, it seems like Tanji's loadout is almost a way to prevent rebel spam, just because you can put T-45s in sockets and a lot of stuff in sockets without really investing in your upkeep or anything along those lines.
Yeah, almost got another leveler that Akroz did, but now Tanji did save it in time. Now we'll start to work on those rebels that are out on the ground. Akroz still just putting down so much damage with his Warthog primary, and getting chased down by Tanji now. Tanji does have stasis. Oh, and does finish off Akroz.
He came up. Akroz came up too.
Yeah, quickly. Too fast. I didn't know. I don't know why he decided to lift off at that time. I would have assumed he would have done, you know, the walk around a little bit, regen, so it'll be a little bit safer to lift off. But decided to lift off really, really fast. And Tanji, with that extra Blaster Guardian, was able to kill him in the air.
Look at Akroz. 16,000 credits to Tangibility's 2,000. This is where it's going to start deciphering gameplay, is just Akroz's income compared to Tangibility.
Well, a lot of Akroz's credits are in his bank, but a lot of Tanji's credits are out on the field. He has 101 upkeep right now, so you can pretty much see where all of his credits have gone, and that is pretty much to all the units that he has on the field right now. He has a lot of T-45s, he has a lot of Jokers out on the field, so, I mean, the credit income, although yes, it is pretty pretty different. I don't know if it's game-breakingly different. So we will see what will happen when we hit the late game. Akroz does have that bot spawner for late game, which, you know, paired with rebels, I can see a bot spawner doing like horrendous damage. Tanji already hitting level 7.
Level 4. Especially on Chasm.
Yeah, on Chasm. There's going to be so many. But Tanji has already hit level 7. And Akroz, with Blaster Guardians of his own, not able to snipe that leveler, but now has to run from Tanji. Oh, I think Tanji might be able to get this finished. Akroz does drop and starts regen, but does run into that T-45. Oh, no. And Akroz does get finished off on the ground. Those rebels are getting handled pretty quickly by on the ground, and Tanji has been able to hold pretty well. Although he did lose two levelers right at the beginning of the game, he's been able to kind of, I guess, not necessarily come back as if he was behind, but kind of even the score here, even the match and repositioning Seekers there. Akros has rebels all over the map, and now starting to send to bring some over to that top. Making a secret stash there. Tanji does catch him in the act, so he probably will be able to scout those rebels. Watching a flyover will get you suspicious, especially on Chasm. Definitely does see it and will start to attack them. And now Akros is going to send some more rebels out, but they are pretty much going to get finished down on the ground by Tanji and his Blaster Guardians. God, those Blaster Guardians.
Tanji is doing a phenomenal job. A lot of Seekers, a lot of T-45s, a lot of anti-air, which is really preventing Akros from doing that harassment that he has done before with that Warhawk.
Yeah, and the way that he, just because of the map, even if they did that, even if other players did that in the maps before, in the games before, because they were not on Chasm, they would not have been able to stand up to all the rebels, spam, 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 but because there is no way for the rebels to reach the other side of the map, Tanji is pretty much completely safe and can do whatever he wants, and as long as he puts up enough AA, and that's enough to fend off the Hog that's able to come over to the other side of the map. And that's what's enabling him to do what he's doing right now. And now starting to work on mid, has a goalie here and a honeypot again, bringing the honeypot up ahead. And Akros still with more rebels. I really am very, very curious to see what Akros decides to do with this, with rebels on this map. How he can make rebel spam work. And I definitely think that he has a plan.
If Akros gets mid, I think it will work fantastic for him. Because
yes,
it will spread him across so much. If Akros can cap mid, he'll be fine. However, if Tanji gets mid, Akros is really going to be hurting, especially in map control, with Tanji being able to travel across that fast map and that Neo.
Yeah, exactly. If Akros grabs mid, he will definitely be able to get it defended and surrounded well. So it won't be re-neutralized, because just rebels on each side will definitely be enough to prevent it from getting neutralized. Tanji loses that T-45 to Akros. But Akros, trying to transform down, is followed by a Seeker missile and actually does get finished off on the ground. Now Tanji will be able to secure mid in the time that Akros is respawning. A honeypot going down, will get a lot of salvage and heal at the same time. And Akros now coming back to the game with that respawn delay. God, it's so painful when you're used to that respawn for like a year or more, which is what these players have been playing for, that it's just so painful to have to wait like a little bit of time. The little bit of time really does make a huge difference. But Tanji able to take down a lot of the rebels over here, using some Jokers as a meat shield so he can just fire in with his Blaster Guardian Neo. And we have a couple rebels just getting sent out by Akros, but it's not that many. It's only five. It's only a build queue's worth. And it's going to meet up with these goalies, and I don't know how well they will hold up. Not very well. They're dying.
Yep, and there are rebels now on the top side going with those neutrals. They are being destroyed. Looks like that Longhorn is... Now, Akros is coming to help out, though, so there goes the Longhorn. And Akros now is beginning to clear out these neutrals, which I think she should have done in quarter one.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if he could have. There was no real way to keep Tanji from screwing with him while he did that. But now that Tanji has mid, Akros can use mid as a distraction, putting a lot of pressure on mid. And I think that's what enabled him to just sit there, fire, use those rebels as a shield, and actually clear that bridge. And now Akros has one more avenue of attack. Actually, not necessarily one more, but one real avenue of attack with these rebels. And now he is switching out his levelers. I'm assuming for Moneymaker, so he can sustain that spam ability for those rebels. Not quite queuing up Moneymakers yet, but he is already level 7, so he can make. He doesn't even have goalies in his loadout. God. Oh, but gets finished off by Tanji on the way back to that power station. Tanji with three Blaster Guardians. Oh my god, he can kill rebels like immediately now. Now two of them did get killed, but he still can get quite a lot killed. And Tanji does see that the bridge is clear, so he might want to start putting some radar kind of stuff to be able to, detect whenever Akros decides to send some stuff over. This is like playing against Osprey. What does that mean? Oh man, that's so weird. I'm not really sure what aspect of playing against an Osprey he is implying that it's like, but maybe I don't know. I'm not gonna make any guesses. If anybody knows what the hell he's talking about, please let us know in chat.
Tanji's ability is at zero energy draw right now, so it's going to be hurting him. Tanji's ability does go down.
Oh.
But Akros, you know, really needs to take this as an advantage right now and do some harassment on Tanji's ability.
And trying to kill this T-45 with a Seeker right next to it, that is a little bit dangerous, but as a level 7 hog, it was able to kill that T-45, and the Seeker will go down
and
as well. Levels up, probably will be able to neutralize this mid. I don't know how predictive that will be, because Creeps will just walk back in. Tanji finally respawning now, but will be a third of a second before we can move. Oh, and Akros almost able to kill the... Oh, he's hitting this goalie from the back. That's doing quite a lot of damage. Tanji, okay, does save it. Brings some creeps to take this mid back. And now we are back to where we were with less defenses on the back for Tanji. Oh, nope, he replenishes that soccer and... That Seeker and that T-45. For some reason, I was going to say saucer, which doesn't make any sense. But now Akros again doing his harass, but now Tanji is there to micro and defend, but now we have a push over the bridge by Akros. That is a lot of rebels. That is quite a lot of rebels, and I think they were set on capture because he set so many rebels on capture that they won't diverge away from their path that he would want them to take, so they are kind of all over. And now we will see the rebel spam that Akros has been doing this entire game. He has been able to clear one bridge. I would really, really like to see him clear the other one. And still more rebels are coming out. Those creeps are walking over that bridge. Oh, but the rebels are going for the mid instead. Akros can kind of use them as a shield and just fire in with his own fire, but I don't know how effective that will be. They will die pretty quick to those goalies.
Oh,
now,
here comes
Oh, boy. And it's a little bit too late. I mean, obviously, he probably should have done this a little bit earlier, probably during the beginning of this quarter to stop that, income. But both of these players have
this income going away. Akros takes out Tanji's ability, so it is going to stop this Goliath. But at the same time, that's a lot of damage and a lot of income that Tanji's ability prevented him. Both of them have plus 60,000 credits right now. That's a lot of credits.
Yeah, actually, Tanji has plus 76, and I don't know what he's going to do with them. Goalies is the thing that makes the most sense, but on this map, I don't know why he hasn't sold his levelers off yet, because he's already level 13, but he really needs to sell all those levelers off, I think, so he can just make more goalies and actually sustain more out on the field.
What Akros needs to do is continue to concentrate on killing tangibility. That's one thing that really helps advance with that rebel.
Oh, yeah.
Is when your opponent is not there. That's one thing right now that Akros was able to do against his opponents. That's what he was able to do against. He was able to do against Ernitra and able to do against Wolf Cub, was constantly kill off his opponents.
Yeah, and when his opponent's not on the field, because he is such a strong mech, he is a warthog, he can snipe away and kill whatever units he wants. Now Tanji finally selling off the rest of his levelers, replacing them with T-45s, now definitely going to have a lot of attack power out on the field. There's still more levelers here on the top outpost, and Akros just massing up more and more rebels. He has the bottom has been cleared. I didn't notice when that happened. Did you notice when that happened, Kirby? Because that happened.
Okay. That was happening directly when Tangibility was doing that Goliath drop on the
See. So now both bridges are clear. Akros can kind of do whatever he wants at this point, except that the fact that Tanji has mid. If Akros can take mid, then that would be really amazing for him and would be able to control this entire game. There will be too many rebels all over the map for him to handle. I don't know why he hasn't resocketed his, those levelers that he sold, moneymakers, and just more and more rebels, I would think at this point, is pretty much how the strategy works. And so if he can just continually pump them out, even though he has plenty of credits now, he might not later when he just buys more and more rebels. So...
And I want to say, I think the thing that's really helping Tangibility right now prevent this rebel spam is the no money makers, but using these T-45s to place them on there, because it's that defense that you have, but you're not paying for, if that makes sense.
Yeah, you don't have to suffer in terms of power for those T-45s on the socket. If you have a bunch of money makers on the field, that's great. That does give you credit, and that is helping you on the socket. But those sockets can be reallocated should money not really be the problem. If it's
here
power,
it
that's the problem.
Here is Tangibility moving eight Goliath, 12,
a lot of Seekers.
12 Seekers, really close to that. It's going to be close. And he's setting all the Seekers on follow on the Goliath 2 so they don't rush out in front.
So I don't know if Akros can really... I mean, look at all the Rebels at his front door. Obviously, Tanji is probably going to reposition all these goalies once they get there. But Akros has a huge wall at his front door of like four
bombs.
Rebels thick. Yeah, and he's bombing.
The bombs.
Oh, man, those Seekers are really, really preventing him from doing anything over there.
Oh, that's going to hurt.
So let's see if he can actually get those. He really wants the Seekers dead, I think, is probably, that's what he was going for at first. Oh my god, that's a lot of Seeker missiles following. That is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Seekers. Oh man, that's a lot of Seekers, and a lot of goalies as well, and all Akros here has here at the mid, or at his fort, are Rebels, and Tanji coming out with another Seeker and 5 Blaster Guardians. Tanji is level 14, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, this is not looking good for Tanji. And
Akros.
Taking out those Rebels is really just going to be able to start hitting the front door. Akros is bob-spamming, but I don't think it's going to be enough for this.
I mean, goalies have so much life. He's able to kill the ones in the front, but now Tanji repositioning, getting a good surround. This looks like it is going to be the end of the game.
Yep, and here is that Seeker on that Warthog. That's Akros will not be able to survive that.
Yeah, not going to be able to get any blocking off, and Tanji, and, okay, this game is over. Akros does go down in defeat. So game one goes to Tangibility. I'm assuming Akros is going to counterpick Duel, so let's see if that is the case. And Akros did get a Halloween crate, yeah.